Hi, I'm Rongji. In today's video, I'm going to introduce you how to do cellular V2X sighting conformance test by using Keysight signal generation and the signal analysis software. Here's the agenda. At first, I will give you an overview of cellular V2X. After that, I will introduce you Keysight solutions for the non-signaling physical layer test. At last, I will give you a live demo with NR-V2X and LTE V2X signals. Now, let's get started with the first part. The first cellular V2X standard based on the 4G LTE air interface was developed on the release 14 and was further enhanced in release 15 by 3GPP. Broadcast communication was the only supported cast tap in LTE V2X. The main intention in LTE V2X was as part of use cases to provide road safety, fulfilling the demanding reliability and latency requirements. So the PC5 interface for the direct communication was created and its operating band is in the 5.9 GHz band. Release 16 is the first to introduce V2X communications, including silent communications based on the 5G new radio air interface and a basis for the future enhancements and extensions. It supports several communication mechanisms such as unicast, broadcast, and groupcast. The goal of NR-V2X is to support advanced use cases such as extended sensors, advanced driving. These use cases have requirements that cannot be satisfied by the LTE V2X standard, so the NR-V2X has been developed to complement and not replace LTE V2X. LTE V2X will involve parallel to become the part of the 5G platform. 3GPP defines two operating bands for the new radio V2X PC5 in the frequency range 1, which is 2.5 GHz band and 5.9 GHz band. Next, let's take a quick overview of 5G new radio V2X architecture defined by the 3GPP. In this video, I will focus on PC5 silent communications. Release 16 specifies the communications of the two types of PC5 interfaces, which are NR-PC5 and LTE-PC5, supporting roaming and inter-public land mobile network cooperation. The PC5 reference point may be used in case of the V2V, vehicles to vehicles, V2P, vehicles to pedestrians, like our smartphones, vehicle to the infrastructure. In addition to broadcast, NR-V2X introduces groupcast and unicast, building a more complete V2X system. The mechanism of the discovery of unicast users for the silent communication can use broadcast and the response to discover the neighboring user equipment and set up direct peer-to-peer unicast communications. So in the future, V2X architecture will utilize the hybrid network technologies as shown here. Most devices and the chipsets need support LTE V2X and the NR-V2X at the same time. Next, let's talk about Keysight solutions for cellular V2X non-signaling physical layer test. At first, let's take an overview of portfolio. Keysight provides you multiple test software to cover all test cases of cellular V2X. To do NR-V2X physical layer test, you can use latest PathWave signal generation test software with N7632 EMBC license to generate signal and use X-series measurement applications with N9085 EM4E license to do signal analysis. Meanwhile, if you are doing LTE V2X test, you can use PathWave N7626C signal studio to generate the signal and use XAP N9080 EM0E LTE V2X modulation measurement application to do the signal analysis. What's more, Keysight provides you PathWave signal studio to generate GNSS signal with N7609C license as well. Once you have set up your signals in the PathWave signal generation for the cellular V2X application, you can download them to a variety of Keysight signal generators such as MXG, VXG, or modular PXIE VXT platforms. XApps for the cellular V2X application supports benchtop spectrum analyzers such as MXA, PXA, and modular PXIE instruments. This software complements this platform by providing a cost-effective way to tailor them to your test needs in design and development. Next, let's see how these products can support your test. First, let's talk about the component and the transmitter test. Here's an example. The DUT is connected between the Keysight signal generator and the Keysight signal analyzer via the IF cable. In the rear panel, you need connector, 10 MHz reference ports, trigger ports via the IF cables as well. Then on your PC, you can use PathWave signal generation desktop software to make live LAN connection to the signal generator and create the cellular V2X waveform with valid license. After that, the cellular V2X waveform can be downloaded to the signal generator to playback. PathWave X-Series measurement application is running on the signal analyzer. You can analyze the NR-V2X signal with N9085 EM4E measurement application and use N9080 EM4E measurement application for the LTE V2X signal. Next, let's talk about the receiver test. The first scenario is the DUT is integrated with GNSS module, and it is the most use case. So we can directly connect a PPS port to the trigger port of the signal generator. Then on your PC, you can use PathWave signal generation desktop software to make the live LAN connection to the signal generator and create the cellular V2X waveform with valid license. After that, the cellular V2X waveform can be downloaded to the signal generator to playback. This enables you to create channel-coded signals for the receiver bit error rate or block error rate, packet error rate analysis. Meanwhile, it supports you to do performance verification and functional test of receivers during the baseband integration and system verification. Another use case is using PCPES from the OTA GPS receiver. Then you need connect trigger and reference ports between GPS receiver module and the signal generator via the IF cables. If your DUT is not integrated with GNSS module and you do not have the GPS receiver, then you can use the MXG to emulate the GNSS module paired with the N7609C signal studio software to generate and playback GNSS waveform via the LAN connection. Next, I will show you a live demo of NR-V2X conformance test. The hardware platforms I used here are N5182B MXG and N9020B MXA. First, I will show you how to generate the NR-V2X signal. So, in the PWSG desktop software, press NR-V2X button to open up this NR-V2X application. Here we can see that under Carrier tab, it provides you Carrier Settings configuration page. Click on the bandwidth setup for the bandwidth part settings such as RB allocations and channel setup for the sign link channels configuration. According to the latest 3GPP specification, it provides you synchronized channels, controlled channels, shared channels for the user data, and feedback channels and CSI IS channels. So in the bottom status bar, it shows the hardware is not connected to the PWSG desktop. So let's go to the hardware tab, press hardware button on top bar to config hardware connection at first. It supports different types of signal generator. So let's pick X-Series signal generator here. Then the X-Series signal generator subpage displays here. Press it. In address menu, let's type in or select the IP address of the instruments we want to use. Press connect button. After a few seconds, I can see that I have a status of connected in the bottom of the window. PWSG for NR-V2X application provides you several quick setups according to the 3GPP technical specification. So you can click on TX config button to do quick setup for the transmitter test, or you can click on the FRC config button to do quick setup for the receiver test. Now in our demo, let's do the transmitter test. So in TX config quick setup page, let's select bandwidth with FR1 30 MHz, LCS 30 kHz, RB location set as out for field, modulation 64 com, press OK. All settings for the transmitter test will be automatically set for you based on the spec defined. So go to the PSCCS channels in the configuration page. Now we can see that the allocation slot is from 0 to 19. First symbol index is 1 with number of symbol length is 3. PWSG for NR-V2X application provides you the resource allocation graph to help you easily identify each channel's allocation here. So you can click off PSSCH0 in the resource graph to disable its display. Now we can see that PSCCH channel resource allocation much more clearly. Click off display detail here, the channel allocation in one slot graph will disappear. If you want to see details of resource allocation in one slot, so remember to click on it. Next, let's go to the PSSCH channels. We can see that slot allocation is set from 0 to 90, RB number is 75 RB, and modulation scheme is 64 QAM, which is as expected. Now, in the resource graph, you can click off control channels and only display PSSCH channels to verify your user data settings. Click on the summary button here. You can get a quick overview of settings you config for the different carriers, bandwidths, and the different type of channels. Next, let's go to the hardware page to config the center frequency. According to the NR-V2X operating band for the PC5 interface, let's set the center frequency to 5.9 GHz. Now we can click on Generate and Download button here. After a few seconds, the NR-V2X waveform will be generated and downloaded to the connected signal generator. And in the waveform tab, you can see the generated IQ waveform graph, spectrum graph, and the CCDF curve. PWSG also supports you to export your configuration setting file. So I will show you how to utilize this PWSG setting file to do fast measurement later. Now we can switch to accept to see how to demodulate it. Click on the tab of the main tab to open up this mode measurement view select screen. Select 5G NR-V2X, modulation analysis, normal view, and press OK. Press record button here, go to the demodulation info tab, select CC setup. Press record from, select the configuration file saved from PWSG to do the quick configurations. We can see the demodulation is correct now. Let's check the settings if it is expected. Go to the mass setup tab. We can see the link direction is uplinked now. And in the component carrier configuration page, side link is clicked on. Go to the channel profile tab, press control and user channels button to open up channel configuration page. We can see that PSCCH and PSSCH channel settings are same as we set in the PWSG. Next, I will show you how to do fast results display. Go to the display menu, select view tab, press normal 3x3. Now you can quickly get constellation diagram, spectrum, roaming time trace, detected allocations, IE power 3D trace, error vector 3D trace, frame summary. In the frame summary, you can get EVM results for the different bandwidth part and the frequency error in the each subframe. And in the error summary table, you can get the EVM results based on the carrier, IQ offset, frequency error, and etc. So in the user summary, you can get EVM results and modulation scheme for the each channel. Next, I will show another powerful feature to do signal analysis. So go to mass setup menu, select channel profile tab, press control and user channels button here to open up this channel configuration page. Go to the summary tab, click off PSSCH state. Now PSSCH and PSSCH DMRS are excluded from the measurement, so you can focus on the controlled channels verification. If you want to analyze the user data channel only, then you click off the controlled channel state and click on the user data channel state. Now PSCCH and PSCCH DMRS are excluded from the measurement. Next, I will show you how to use 3D traces in the markers. Right click on any spell space to open up this pop-up window. Click on XY plane to see error vector time trace. You can modify the axis range. Let's set this to 14. Now it shows you the first slot error information. Click on ZY plane to see error vector spectrum trace. You can modify the axis range to 12. Now you can see the first RB allocation results. Click on mark setting to quickly switch to the mark menu. Now let's modify the subcarrier index to 6. Then we can get EVM results at specific allocation via the marker. Click on reset button to reset all modifications to the 3D traces. Double click on window 6 to go back on NR-V2X measurement screen. You can not only do the demodulation measurement, but also do the power measurement. In the measurement field, select screen, select 5G NR-V2X channel power measurement, press OK. We get total channel power and power spectral density for this NR-V2X signal. If you go to the OBW measurement, then you will get pass-fail results there. In this case, we can see the signal is passed. You can do the ACP SEM power measurement listed here as well. To learn more, I highly recommend you download the latest X app and have a try. Next, I will give you a live demo of LTE V2X conformance test. The hardware platforms I used here are MXG and MXA. First, let's go to N7626C Signal Studio to do the LTE V2X signal generation. It provides you component carriers for the carrier settings, V2X side link for the bandwidth settings, and channel setup for the different type of channel settings. Click on V2X side link and press V2X FRC wizard button to do quick setup. Here, select bandwidth as 10 MHz, FRC type as FRC for the reference sensitivity. Press OK. All settings for the receiver test will be automatically set for you based on the specification defined. Now go to the instrument page, modify the center frequency to 5.9 GHz, click on the system button to make the LAN connection to the signal generator. Once it is successful, you can see that I have a status of connected. Go to the hardware page, you can see the detailed information of your hardware as well. Now click on the generate and the download button. After a few seconds, the LTE V2X waveform will be downloaded to the signal generator. Next, let's switch to X app to do signal analysis. In the measurement view select screen, select LTE V2X modulation analysis measurement basic view and press OK. N9080EM4E LTE V2X modulation analysis measurement can do auto detection and preset for you to do fast demodulation. So let's see how to do it. In the carrier reference frequency menu, you set the correct center frequency. In the radio tab, the link is uplink now. And in the component carrier configuration page, carrier side link mode select as V2X. And in the mass standard tab, press 10 MHz to do FRC preset. Then all the modulation settings will be configured automatically. If you want to show more results, you can go to the display menu, select grid as 2x3. Now measurement results window increased to 6 windows. You can add a roaming time choice in window 5, or you can modify the window 2 data from spectrum to the detected allocations. In window 6, you can add frame summary results, press OK. Now you can get constellation diagram, error vector spectrum, roaming time trace, detected allocations, error summary, and frame summary for all channels at the same time. Quite a lot of information, right? Next, I will show you how to only display results of your interested channels. So we can go to main setup menu, select channel profile tab, press edit sidelink channels button. Go to the user summary tab, click off the PSCCH present state. Now PSCCH and the PSCCH DMRS are excluded from the measurement now, and you can focus on the user data channels verification. In error summary table, XApp also provides you pass-fail indicator of in-band emission test and the spectrum flatness test. And in the frame summary, you can get EVM, modulation format, power, RB number of each channel results. So in summary, XNAP provides you a comprehensive set of tools to analyze cellular V2X side link signals based on the 3GPP specification, and they support various Keysight hardware platforms to meet your test need. To learn more and to download a free trial, visit us at this website. Thanks for watching.